So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247, where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. And remember guys, these sessions are important for the current affairs of ESI section of both the exams RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session. But before we begin guys, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and you can also join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information regarding the daily sessions and also about the courses. So let's talk about the very first question, which is about the newly launched scheme, which is known as Yuva. Consider the following statements with regard to Yuva scheme for mentoring young authors and author mentorship program, and you have to identify the correct statement out of these three. So let's talk about this scheme, and remember it has been launched by the Ministry of Education headed by Dr. Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank. His Lok Sabha constituency is Haridwar, which is of course in Uttarakhand, and it has been launched through the Department of Higher Education. And remember, Yuva has a full form also, which is Young, Upcoming and Versatile Authors. So do remember the full form also, Young, Upcoming and Versatile Authors. And remember, it is an author mentorship program. It will provide mentorship to the young authors. Young authors ko mentorship provide karai jayegi, how they can be a good author. And also remember guys, it is a part of India at 75 project when we are completing 75 years of our independence. And the basic objective guys of this project is to train young and budding authors who are below 30 years of age to inculcate in them the habit of reading, the habit of writing. Basically unko author banane ke liye mentorship provide karai jayegi through this scheme which is known as Yuva. And remember, this scheme is in line with the Prime Minister's vision to encourage young writers to write about the India's freedom struggle. And also the implementing agency will be the National Book Trust, which means all the books that will be selected for publishing will be published by the National Book Trust India. And the books will also be translated into other Indian languages to ensure the exchange of culture and literature, which will promote Ek Bharat and Shreshth Bharat. And a scholarship will also be provided worth ₹50,000 per month for a period of 6 months per author under the mentorship scheme, which is known as Yuva. Ab 50,000 per month diye jayenge, par kitno ko diye jayenge? How many numbers of scholarship will be provided? How many numbers of authors will be selected? So there will be a selection procedure under which a total of 75 authors will be selected through an All India contest that is to be conducted through mygov.in. These young authors will be provided mentorship through the other authors and the mentors. And remember, the manuscripts are targeted to be completed by 15 December 2021 and the published books will be launched on 12th January 2020, the year when we are completing 75 years of independence. And why 12th January? Because we all know that is the National Youth Day or the Yuva Divas, the birthday of great Swami Vivekananda. So this was about this news guys, and now let's come back to the question. You have to identify correct statements here. Yuva stands for Young, Ultimate and Versatile Author. No, that is not ultimate, that is upcoming. Okay, that is upcoming. Ye bilkul usi tarike se sound ho raha hai. Agar aapne Fir Hera Feri dekhi hai, to usme Akshay Kumar ke paas ek degree hoti hai, ITUS, International Talent of Ultimate Student. So ye bilkul usi tarike se sound ho raha hai yahan pe, but here it is not ultimate, it's upcoming. This scheme is for the authors below the age of 35 years, not the 35 years. It's for the people who are below 30 years of age. An implementing agency for this will be the National Book Trust India. This is absolutely correct. So we have only one statement which is correct here. Option C, only three will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number two, which is again a very important question. It is about the PM Cares for Children scheme. And you have to identify one statement which is incorrect here regarding the scheme, which is known as PM Cares for Children scheme. Now let's talk about this scheme. So it is a very commendable step, I must say, by the Government of India. This scheme, PM Cares for Children, will provide support to the children, to those children who have lost their parents due to COVID-19. Aise bachche jinke maa baap ka dehant ho gaya hai because of coronavirus, un sabhi children ko support provide karaya jayega through this scheme, which is known as PM Cares for Children. And remember, the whole scheme will be funded from the PM Cares Fund, jo ki last year launched kiya gaya tha to tackle the COVID-19. Us fund mein se puri ki puri is scheme ko fund kiya jayega. Also, all children who have lost both parents or surviving parent or legal guardian or adoptive parents due to COVID-19 will provide support under the scheme. Matlab, ऐसा नहीं है कि केवल उनके जेनेटिक पेरेंट्स अगर खोए हैं की डेथ हुई है तभी उनको सपोर्ट मिलेगा, अगर कोई सर्वाइविंग पेरेंट है अगर उसकी डेथ हो गई है तब भी सपोर्ट मिलेगा, अगर कोई लीगल गार्जियन था कोई अडॉप्टिव पेरेंट्स थे अगर उनकी भी डेथ हो गई है तो भी सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड कराया जाएगा। मतलब अगर जो वो बच्चा है अगर वो चिल्ड्रन है पूरी तरीके से अनाथ हो चुका है ऑर्फन हो चुका है तो उसको वो सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड कराया जाएगा। नाउ देयर इज अ प्रोविजन ऑफ फिक्स्ड डिपॉजिट इन द नेम ऑफ चाइल्ड, सो अ फिक्स्ड डिपॉजिट ऑफ ₹10 lakh अ ह्यूज अमाउंट फॉर ईच चाइल्ड विल बी देयर फॉर व्हेन ही और शी रीचेस 18 इयर्स ऑफ एज एंड रिमेंबर हाउ दिस 10 लाख विल बी प्रोवाइडेड टू द चिल्ड्रन, सो दे विल गेट अ फिक्स्ड मंथली फाइनेंशियल सपोर्ट और द स्टाइपेंड फ्रॉम स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 18 इयर्स ऑफ एज फॉर द नेक्स्ट 5 इयर्स एंड व्हेन द चिल्ड्रन विल अचीव द एज ऑफ 23 इयर्स ही और शी विल गेट द कॉर्पस अमाउंट एज वन टाइम लमसम, जो भी बाकी बचा हुआ अमाउंट होगा वो उसको एक बार में मिल जाएगा ऑन अचीविंग द एज ऑफ 23। देयर इज अ प्रोविजन ऑफ स्कूल एजुकेशन इन टू कैटेगरीज ऑल्सो, फर्स्ट फॉर दोज चिल्ड्रन हु आर अंडर 10 इयर्स ऑफ एज द एडमिशन विल बी प्रोवाइडेड इन द नियरेस्ट केंद्रीय विद्यालय और इन अ प्राइवेट स्कूल एज अ डे स्कॉलर एंड रिमेंबर इफ द एडमिशन इज प्रोवाइडेड इन अ प्राइवेट स्कूल देन द फीस विल बी एज पर द राइट टू एजुकेशन नॉर्म्स एंड दैट विल ऑल्सो बी गिवन बाय पीएम केयर्स राइट। And what about for the children between 11 to 18 years? They also will be provided with admission in any central government residential school such as Sainik School, Navodaya Vidyalaya or nearest Kendra Vidyalaya or in a private school also they can get admission as a day scholar. And again for the private school the fees will be provided through PM CARES as per the right to education norms. There is a provision of health insurance also, that's very very important thing for a children. Unko health insurance agar jab tak nahi diya jayega tab tak मतलब यू नो उनकी जो ओवरऑल होलिस्टिक डेवलपमेंट है उसके ऊपर ध्यान नहीं रखा जा सकता। ऑल चिल्ड्रन विल बी एनरोल्ड एज अ बेनिफिशियरी अंडर द अम्ब्रेला स्कीम आयुष्मान भारत प्रधानमंत्री जन आरोग्य योजना विद अ हेल्थ इंश्योरेंस कवरेज ऑफ ₹5 lakhs। सो ये बहुत ही अच्छा स्टेप उठाया गवर्नमेंट ने आई मस्ट से एंड द प्रीमियम अमाउंट फॉर दीज चिल्ड्रन टिल द एज ऑफ 18 विल बी पेड बाय द पीएम केयर फंड। देयर इज ऑल्सो प्रोविजन फॉर सपोर्ट ऑफ हायर एजुकेशन एंड फॉर हायर एजुकेशन एजुकेशनल लोन्स विल बी प्रोवाइडेड फॉर द professional courses in India as per the existing educational loan norms, okay? And जहाँ पे भी scholarship का provision है तो वहाँ पे educational loan की जगह scholarship will be provided equivalent to the tuition fees or the core fees for undergraduate or vocational courses as per the government norms that will be provided under this scheme. So I must say it is a very good scheme that has been launched by the government of India. अगर इसकी implementation बहुत अच्छे से हो जाती है तो it will provide support to thousands of children who have lost their parents due to this pandemic. And here you have to identify the incorrect statement. The scheme will be funded from the PM CARES fund, absolutely correct. It is for the children who lost their both blood related parents, not only blood related parents. So I think this will be the incorrect statement, but let's read out the other statements also. A corpus of ₹10 lakh for each child when he or she reaches 18 years of age will be given, absolutely correct. All children will be enrolled as a beneficiary under Ayushman Bharat scheme and insurance coverage of ₹5 lakh will be provided. And PM CARES will also pay for expenditure on uniform, textbook and notebook. This is also correct. All the expenditure will be provided to PM CARES, which means option B is incorrect. Therefore, option B will be the correct answer. I hope guys this scheme is clear and now let's come to question number 3, which is somewhat related to the previous scheme, PM CARES scheme for children. The question is, what is the purpose of online tracking portal Bal Swaraj? So let's talk about this Bal Swaraj online tracking portal. So remember, if government wants to provide benefit to the children who have lost their parents, then they also have to keep a track on these children. Unko ye pata karna padega ki ye children kahan hai, kis halat mein hai. Unke baare mein jankari leni padegi. They have to get the details about those children who have lost their parents. And for that, this online tracking portal Bal Swaraj has been launched by National Commission for Protection of Child Rights, which works under the Ministry of Women and Child Development. And it has been done under Section 109 of the Juvenile Justice Act 2015. And as I told you, its objective is online tracking and digital real-time monitoring of the children who have lost both or either of their parents in the COVID-19. So, इसमें हम इतना ही पढ़ना है, इससे ज्यादा डिटेल में नहीं जाना है। इसमें एक चीज मैं आपको और बता देता हूँ, द कमीशन विल क्रिएट अ लिंक बाय द नेम कोविड केयर एंड देयर ऑल द इन्फॉर्मेशन विल बी प्रोवाइडेड बाय द अथॉरिटीज रिगार्डिंग द चिल्ड्रन हु हैव लॉस्ट देयर पेरेंट्स। ओके, सो हियर the purpose is being asked. So here the correct answer is to track children who lost both or either of their parents in COVID-19. Option C will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 4, which is a horticulture, which is about the horticulture cluster development program. And the question is, in the pilot phase, this horticulture cluster development program will be implemented in dash horticulture clusters out of dash clusters selected for the program. Pilot phase mein kitne clusters mein isko launch kiya jayega? Out of the total clusters, you have to tell both the numbers. So remember, the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare, which is headed by Mr. Narendra Singh Tomar, and he is also the Minister of Panchayati Raj and Rural Development and also the Minister of Food Processing Industry, has launched this program, the Horticulture Cluster Development Program. And isme naam se hi pata chal raha hai that the clusters will be developed in for the horticultural crops. Jo horticulture crops ke clusters hain unko develop kiya jayega. That's it. So it aims at growing and developing the identified horticulture clusters to make them globally competitive. And for this, the implementing agency will be the National Horticulture Board, which works under the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. In the pilot phase, the scheme will be implemented in 12 horticulture clusters out of total 53 clusters. And remember, these clusters will be implemented. This scheme will be implemented through cluster development agencies, which are appointed on the recommendations of their respective state or UT governments. And what are the issues that will be addressed with the help of this scheme? These are some of the issues like pre-production, production, post-harvest, management, logistics, marketing and branding. So basically, starting from the pre-production to the marketing and branding of the products, all the key issues will be addressed with the help of this scheme through the implementation of this scheme. And this is a beautiful map showing the 12 clusters and crops of the pilot phase. Like we have Shopian, Jammu Kashmir, apple hai wahan pe, Kutch, Gujarat mein mango hai, Lucknow, UP mango hai. So these are the प्रोडक्ट्स जो कि उस पर्टिकुलर स्टेट के उस पर्टिकुलर एरिया के फेमस हैं. दीज आर द फेमस प्रोडक्ट्स ऑफ दीज एरियाज एंड दीज आर बेसिकली द क्लस्टर्स ऑफ दीज क्रॉप्स इन दीज एरियाज. ओके, सो ये 12 क्लस्टर्स और उनके क्रॉप्स हैं ऑफ दिस पायलट फेज. नाउ रिमेंबर, इट इज टारगेटेड, इट इज एस्टिमेटेड इन फैक्ट दैट इट विल बेनिफिट अबाउट 10 लाख फार्मर्स एंड रिलेटेड स्टेक होल्डर्स ऑफ द वैल्यू चेन. It will also improve the exports of targeted crops by approximately 20%, and it will definitely attract an investment of approximately 10,000 crores when it will be implemented in all the 53 clusters. So obviously investment jo hai wo attract hoga hi hoga, kyunki agar clusters develop honge to ease of doing business badhega, to definitely investment will be attracted in these clusters. बिकॉज अगर कोई भी सेक्टर प्रॉफिट मेकिंग है, इफ एनी सेक्टर इज प्रॉफिट मेकिंग, देन डेफिनेटली जो इन्वेस्टर्स हैं दे आर अट्रैक्टेड टुवर्ड्स दैट पर्टिकुलर सेक्टर. ओके, सो गाइज, दिस वॉज अबाउट दिस स्कीम एंड नाउ लेट्स कम बैक टू द क्वेश्चन. इन डैश हॉर्टिकल्चर क्लस्टर, सो इट विल बी लॉन्च एंड इन 12 हॉर्टिकल्चर क्लस्टर्स आउट ऑफ टोटल 53 इन द पायलट फेज. सो देयरफॉर ऑप्शन ए विल बी द करेक्ट आंसर. And moving ahead to question number 5, which is the last question for today. What is MBTAG? MBTAG kya hai? This is a very simple question and a very easy question. It can be asked in your one marker in the ESI paper. Let's talk about this. MBTAG basically, guys, it is a temperature monitoring, temperature recording device, which has been developed by IIT Roper. And it is a first of its kind Internet of Things device that records real time ambient temperature during the transportation of perishable products, वैक्सीन्स एंड इवन ऑफ द बॉडी ऑर्गन्स एंड द ब्लड. सो इससे फायदा क्या होगा? इससे हमें यह फायदा होगा कि जो हमारे पेरिशेबल प्रोडक्ट्स हैं या कोई भी ऐसी चीज है लाइक वैक्सीन, बॉडी ऑर्गन्स, ब्लड, उनको उनका जो कंड्यूसिव इन्वायरमेंट है उसमें उसको हम रख पा रहे हैं कि नहीं, उसका हमें पता लग पाएगा. तो इससे फायदा ये, द बेनिफिट ऑफ दिस प्रोडक्ट विल बी दैट वी विल बी एबल टू डिटरमाइन दैट वेदर वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग द कंड्यूसिव टेम्परेचर टू द प्रोडक्ट्स दैट वी आर ट्रांसपोर्टिंग. ओके, now talking about more about this device, so it can detect temperature from minus 40 to plus 80 degrees in any time zone for 90 days on a single charge. It will generate an alert when the temperature goes beyond a preset limit. So that is also a very huge advantage of this. Agar kisi perishable product ka jo minimum temperature hai, maan lete hain, let us say there is a product, perishable product A, agar uska minimum jo temperature hai wo माइनस 10 से नीचे नहीं जाना चाहिए और प्लस 20 से ऊपर नहीं जाना चाहिए, सो इन दैट केस इट विल यू नो रेज एन अलार्म, रेज एन अलर्ट अगर टेम्परेचर माइनस 10 या प्लस माइनस 10 से नीचे जाता है या प्लस 20 से ऊपर जाता है. The recorded data can be retrieved by connecting USB with any computer. It is basically a USB device. Remember this also. And also, it was developed by an innovation hub which is known as AWADH, which stands for Agriculture and Water Technology Development Hub, and its startup ScratchNest. And both of these are based in IIT Ropad. So that is why IIT Ropad ke baare mein humne padha tha starting mein ki IIT Ropad ne isko develop kiya hai. But IIT Ropad ke andar ek innovation hub hai aur ek startup hai. Unhone milke isko develop kiya hai. Okay. So what is AmbiTag then? It is a temperature data logger. Option A will be the correct answer. I hope this question is clear. And that's it for the session, guys. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.